In today's Medical Minute, in recent years, experts have seen an alarming uptick in the incidence of colorectal cancer in young adults. New research shows a link between weight and risk. The body mass index is a measure of body fat. It's based on height and weight. As it increases, there's a direct link with your risk of colorectal cancer. People considered obese have a twofold increase in getting colon cancer at a young age. Another study, it looks at sedentary behavior. It found people who watch television for 7 to 14 hours per week had a heightened risk of cancer.
The things that we can control, such as our diet, the amount of exercise we do, smoking or not smoking, and basically your sedentary lifestyle or active lifestyle, those things are all very important. So any chance you can to control the things that you can, it's the best thing to do.
Now he says colorectal cancer is caused by many factors, some we can control and some we can't. To lower the risk, he says it's essential to manage lifestyle factors that are within our control. And we know this is a confusing issue, and a lot of you have questions on all of this. And we're working for you to get answers on exactly when you should get tested. Joined this morning by Carilion Clinic gastroenterologist, Dr. Mythili Chitnovis. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So first off, when should folks get screened?
It depends on their family history and their personal risks, but in asymptomatic individuals, meaning patients who do not have any symptoms and are not at increased risk for colorectal cancer, they should typically begin screening at the age of 50. Now, the American Cancer Society came out with new guidelines issued last year, and they suggest that patients should begin at the age of 45, and that number was 45 for African Americans to begin with.
So really check with your doctor. Also, a lot of folks for insurance companies are going to be a big factor, so check with them as well.
That is a big factor, exactly.
What screening options are available for folks? Because we've always heard about the traditional way. Is that still the best?
Exactly. Colonoscopy is still considered to be the best screening option because it gives people the ability to detect the precancerous lesions and remove them at the same time. The other tests are available, such as Cologuard, which is a DNA-based test, FIT, which is also a stool-based test, and CT colonography are other options, but they would still need to be followed up by a colonoscopy if results came back abnormal.
So really it's an important thing. Just talk to your doctor about what's going to be best for you.
Exactly.
And if you see some symptoms out there, what should maybe bring some alarm to you to make you talk to your doctor sooner?
Exactly. Rectal bleeding is probably one of the most common symptoms of colorectal cancer, and that should tell you to go to your doctor soon. Anemia, unexplained weight loss, abdominal pain, and a change in bowel habits are also important to look for. If patients have any of these, they should go to their doctor sooner. They should not wait for the age of 45 or 50 to get screened for colorectal cancer.
Because that can be the difference between big problems and catching early.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for great information for all of this. And we're going to put more information for you up online at WSLS.com.